Welcome to the audio excerpts of special seminars and conversations with Nalin Narula on GettingPositiveKarmaNow.com.
So we'll start with a little kirtan. And we'll start with the Panch Tattva mantra. Shri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityanand, Shri Advaita Gadadhar, Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktivedanta. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram. Now this next mantra we'll do line-wise and then you follow, okay?
Raghupati Raghav Raja Ram Patit Pavan Sita Ram
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 Sita Ram Sita Ram Sita Ram Jaya Sita Ram
Sita Ram
सीताराम सीताराम जय सीताराम
सीताराम
सियाराम जानकी वल्लभ सीताराम
जय रघुनंदन जय सियाराम जानकी वल्लभ सीताराम
जय रघुनंदन जय सियाराम जानकी वल्लभ जय सियाराम
जय रघुनंदन
राम की जय भक्त हनुमान की जय। सो वी वेलकम दिवाली दिस ईयर एंड वी वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू Happy Diwali to you all. So we are jammed as usual here. Okay, good. Is there any place?
Yes, sir.
Can
chair?
I can take this cushion and sit. Okay, bed here. Everyone's okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So as we know, this is the day when Lord Ram came back to Ayodhya victorious after overcoming Ravan. So Sita, Ram, Lakshman, Hanuman all returned to Ayodhya and they were greeted by the citizens with a lot of fanfare and the whole city was lit up with diyas to celebrate. There were no crackers in those days. So hopefully this year Delhi will be a little cleaner with all the initiatives people have taken to be cracker free. Just wanted to explain a little bit about these mantras that we have been chanting. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we say Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityanand Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktivrind. So what does that mean actually? This is the descent of Lord Krishna himself 500 years back in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he is accompanied by Nityanand, his elder brother, considered Lord Nityanand his elder brother, who is an expansion of Balram, who is Balram himself, from whom Lord Ram comes. So these are direct expansions of Krishna, including Lord Ram, Lord Narsingadev, Parshuram, Matsyavatar, Varah, there are 10 avatars. And then there is a descent from Lord Balram to Pradyumna, Anirudh, Shankarshan and Vasudev. And then there is the second descent of Pradyumna, Anirudh, Shankarshan, Vasudev, and the second Shankarshan is Maha Shankarshan, from whom also come all the Vishnus, from Lord Narayan, who is above, he is in between the first and the second expansion of the primary expansions of the Divine. And on one side is Radharani, and from her are coming Lakshmi Devi, who is the consort of Narayan. And so it is Lakshmi Narayan, it is not Lakshmi Ganesh. Okay? So this is some kind of misconception that has been going on. So Ganesh is the son of Shiva and Parvati, who are way down in the chain. And those are the Shiv Tattva, which is again coming from Shankarshan and Lord Narayan. So there is Vishnu, Mahavishnu, there is Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and then there is Karanodakshaya Vishnu. So Mahavishnu is also known as Shirodakshaya Vishnu. It's the other way around. Karanodakshaya Vishnu, and then there is Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and then there is Shirodakshaya Vishnu, who expands into the supersoul aspect in the heart of every living entity, and who enters the universe. So Vishnu enters the universe this way. Narayan is a little above that. So all these are direct expansions of Lord Narayan, which include Lord Rama. So Advaita Acharya, we chant Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityanand, who is Balram. Advaita Acharya is Mahavishnu himself. And Sita Devi is his wife. So even when he came 500 years ago, he got married to Sita Devi, was a form of Lakshmi. From Lakshmi comes Durga, and from Durga comes Kali. So the Kali Devi is from Durga Devi. So they are of a different flavor. They are in the material expansion of the universe. Gadadhar Pandit, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityanand, Sri Advaita Gadadhar. Gadadhar Pandit is Radharani herself, and a combination of Radharani and Lalita Gopi, Lalita Devi, and Krishna's innermost heart potency, which is the expansion of Reiki. So the Reiki expansion is coming from there. Then you have Srivas, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Prabhu Nityanand, Sri Advaita Gadadhar, Srivas. Srivas is Krishna's pure devotee, who is Narad Muni himself. Srivas Adi. Srivas Adi means these are the five primary, Panch Tattva, and Adi means all the other associates that came with Krishna. So Lord Ram is non-different from Krishna. In the Mahamantra also we have this chanting. And Lord Ram is non-different from Mahavishnu, from Narayan. You can consider like if Krishna is the Adi Purusham, the original Purush, all others are expansions. So it is like the interesting, there is an interesting thing. Even Krishna has does nothing except enjoy and makes people happy, you know. So he is, even Vaikuntha is created by Balram and he maintains it. I mean, Krishna has given this, outsourced everything. He's an outsourced expert. Okay. So he is just there to enliven everybody. And Rupa Goswami has analyzed in Bhakti Rasamrit Sindhu, which is like a code book for Vaishnavas, also known as the Nectar of Devotion. There are 64 qualities that Krishna has. And he has four qualities which are greater than anybody else, including Lord Ram. So Lord Ram is 94% Krishna. He is not 100% Krishna. So those four qualities are, he is the performer of most wonderful activities, especially in his childhood. So no other avatar of Krishna has done something like that. He is also, the second quality is that he is surrounded by devotees who are absolutely fully in love with him, and they are full of love for him. The third quality is that he can attract all living entities just by playing of his flute, which nobody else does. None of the other avatars do. And he has an excellence of beauty which is unsurpassed. He is the most beautiful person in the whole of creation. So even at one time, Lakshmi Devi wanted to enter the, you know, dance with Krishna. So she was told by the gopis, you know, you have too much awe and reverence. You can't be there. You have to be fully in love with him. And so, but we'll, you know, arrange that you see this in a mystic vision. So then she saw this in a mystic vision. So actually Lakshmiji is not allowed to enter Vrindavan. Even if you go to Vrindavan, across the river there is a mandir of Lakshmiji, but there's no Lakshmi temple in Vrindavan. Because she cannot directly enter into the pastimes. Now, she is the wife of Lord Narayan. She knows that Narayan is actually Krishna. So she is not being impure if she wants to dance with Krishna. Right? But because she has too much sense of awe, the gopis don't care. You know, they say, ki, we don't care for anybody. Krishna is it. Husband bhaad mein jaye, family wale bhaad mein jaye, humko koi parwaah nahi hai. So that is a very different mood. So she can't directly enter that mood. So that is something, again, very interesting. So Krishna is, in the Mahamantra, the word Rama is referring to Mahavishnu also. The Ra is the Akshar that is representing Mahavishnu. And Ma is representing Shankarshan or Shiva. So there are many layers to this mantra, the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, that one can chant. And you connect, in fact, with all the expansions of Krishna, including Lord Ram. So Lord Ram had a very particular duty or pastime to execute, which was to show people how to live a life according to the highest rules of Grihastashram, of married life. And like everyone else has experienced, married life is not so easy, right? So everyone faces their challenges. Everyone faces their own difficulties. But he has shown how to be a good husband, how to be a good father, how to be a good son, how to be a good ruler, working for the benefit of the praja, for all the living entities, not just human beings. Praja means whoever has taken janma, pra and ja. Whoever has taken janma in the bhumi is praja. The trees are also praja. The animals are praja. So he was kind to them all, and he ensured that there was a proper treatment of all according to the highest principles of following the rules of Vedic rules, you can say, of how a ruler should be a Kshatriya warrior. He appeared as a Kshatriya warrior. So he had a particular aspect. Lord Narayan before that is where everybody, Narayan means the place where all the living entities lived. So he was living in the, he expanded into the Vishnu forms eventually, and on the ocean, on the Garbhodakshay ocean. And Narayan means to whom all living entities go back also. So there is a lot of, as I said earlier, layers to these aspects of the divine. And by chanting these mantras, we can access all of them. And we can look at the lives of the Panch Tattva, who for this time and age came and represented what it is to be a devotee. The reason that Krishna came as his own devotee is because there is a superior and inferior connection in terms of superior being the worshipable or the worshipped one, and the inferior being the devotees. But then he saw that the devotees were having so much enjoyment and joy. He said, I wonder what this tastes like. I have never experienced this, because I don't know what it is to be a devotee. So then he came as his own devotee, and he was accompanied by all his closest expansions and confidants and friends. So we can connect with, although Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared as a, eventually as a sannyasi, we must understand that he went through the process of revealing who he was. He showed his Vishnu form, he showed all his forms, he showed his Krishna form during his pastimes in Vrindavan. So these are the very confidential, in Navadvip, but which is actually the hidden Vrindavan. So these are the very confidential appearance of Lord Krishna in Kali Yuga. He is supposed to have come in Kali Yuga as a hidden avatar, so this was the hidden avatar. And he was accompanied by Lord Ram, he was accompanied by Mahavishnu, he was accompanied by Balaram, he was accompanied by Radharani, Narad Muni, who is the spiritual master of all mankind. So these are not small things to look at. And these are very incomprehensible in a way. So the proper study is considered, you study the Bhagavad Gita to understand the whole of creation and what is the place of Vishnu, what is the place of Ram, what is the place of Krishna. And then you come to Bhagavatam to understand more deeply about the universe, very expanded knowledge. And then finally the post-PhD study is Chaitanya Charitamrita and books like The Nectar of Devotion. Maybe at some point we can take up the study of Nectar of Devotion, which is a very analytical study by Rup Goswami. It is a listing, very precise listing of who Krishna is, what are his pastimes, and there are so many instances given. And it is very fascinating and enjoyable to read those. So at some point if you can get a copy of Nectar of Devotion, you can read that and see how it goes. Diwali is a time where you should light up your own inner illumination to know who you are and where you are going beyond what you are doing in the material zone. Because in the material zone of existence, whatever you achieve at the end of it, it is what have you gained actually. Where do you go after the end of your life? What do you take with you? So you have to not be concerned about today so much in terms of your material life, where things will happen. As you do your healing, as you do your work, things will happen to give you enough to keep you supported. But if you are busy only going in the direction of getting material gains, then that is like King Sisyphus, if you remember from the Greek mythology, the king of Corinth, who was a very cunning, money-minded king, very devious, and always pompous and showing, you know, doing things for, look at how great I am, what a great man I am. And then he was punished. He was punished by, he had to take a big boulder, roll it up all the way up the hill, labor to get it there. The boulder would then immediately go down again and he had to start all over again. So we are doing something like that in our material lives. You are accumulating so many things, you are working for gain by all kinds of means, fair and foul. And then at the end of the day, then again you start in your next body, in your next life. So the intelligent will say, okay, you know, how much am I going to continue with this? So then you need to look seriously to getting out of this material zone. And you have to do that by working towards illuminating your inner consciousness so that you find your path to the spiritual home, because that is where we all need to go. So on this Diwali, make this a goal that we are going to light our way into our spiritual home by focusing more on that, by studying it, by concentrating, by cleansing the mirror of your mind, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, by chanting the Maha Mantra, by chanting these mantras. So you have two very simple magical mantras. One is the Panch Tattva Mantra, which we have talked about and we chanted, and then the other is the Maha Mantra. So those are very powerful weapons against Maya, and if you chant those internally, externally, focus on your ultimate goal of life while enjoying what you have today. It is not necessary to become a sannyasi to reach the spiritual. Prahlad Maharaj told all his schoolmates, and Prahlad Maharaj is one of the 12 Mahajans, great souls, the son of Hiranyakashipu, the demon, who turned the whole universe upside down. He captured all the demigods, made life miserable for them. Such a powerful person. And ultimately he told, Prahlad Maharaj told his friends, you know, Krishna is not very happy if you are Brahminical. He is not very happy if you have a bath every day, although you should. But he is not very happy if you flatter him in any way. It is only by devotional service. So you can only win him by devotional service. That's it. Nothing more. So I would suggest that you focus and think about these things. The human form of life is very rare. You don't get it very often. When you get it, you must use it to progress to your best position. I was encouraged, as I may have shared with a few of you, two of our students, they said that, you know, they were immigrating to some country, and they said that it's a husband and wife, and they said that, you know, we're really not looking to make money. We are just going to live a very simple, happy life as we are doing even now. And we have no great ambition to become huge experts in our field or anything like that. But we want to concentrate on getting out of this repeated cycle of birth and death. So that was something which was very encouraging, that somewhere the illumination is there that actually driving people to work in that direction. This can happen for you at any time, any age. It's not a restriction or a bar. But please don't do this artificially. You know, go through it sensibly. If you are in household life, then you must discharge your functions, your duties, your obligations. You can't run away. Then you will be called to account somewhere, sometime. So better to discharge your debts. Obligations, duties are debts actually. They are non-different from debts. Because these are owings. So happily do and become debt-free. No more credit card business. Okay. So you can start by getting rid of your credit card debts. That will be actually a way. The day you are credit card debt-free means that you could be free. So use that as a sign. So how many of you have credit card debt? Okay, so get rid of it, then you'll be free.
So I have a healing story to share.
Yes.
Related to credit cards.
Hanji.
So I was sending a healing to one, so I had to pay for my Canada thing, so it was a large amount, and they want you to put it on credit card. Because apparently internationally you're supposed to put it on your card. So I put it on that, and I thought of giving it off in, slowly and steadily. And so I planned for this month, and I also was sending healing simultaneously that I'm free from credit card, I'm free from debts. I didn't specifically mention credit card debts.
Okay.
And then there was that fraud that happened in my account, and
right.
every little thing was wiped out.
Huh.
So whatever was left in my account uh-huh. was wiped out. So in the usual frame of mind, I would really get upset and panic and feel very bad about it, but this time somehow I just didn't. Like I just sent healing to it. And within a week I got a call from my chartered accountant telling me that there is this heavy amount that is being credited into your account. And it's exactly the same amount that I need to pay my credit card debt.
So that was credited from where?
It was some rebate that I completely forgotten about it.
Okay.
Yeah, I had no idea it was supposed to come. It was when it was going to come, how it was going to come. Nothing. He just called me. He says, and it's the exact same amount that I need to, pay off every bit of my credit card.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
So thank you so much. I mean, sometimes I realize that when I panic, and don't send the healing, things just don't go right. But it's just sometimes just being in surrender is the best.
Yes, you must connect with your healing no matter what, whether things are going bad, good. Keep connecting with it. That is what is required. So anybody wants to share anything or have a question?
I got referred back from my tax department, so and it was a huge amount. So I was also sending healing that I'm free from the debts. I got that refund, so I paid my credit card bill.
Good, good.
Thank you so
good,
much for that.
Good. Very good.
So I was not expecting that I'll get such a huge amount back from the tax department. So
lucky.
Some people chant Namyo Regegyo.
Yeah, let them chant Namyo Regegyo.
That's okay. That?
How is that? I don't know. It's all right. It's nothing to do with this. Really. It's a Buddhist mantra. One can chant. The true Lord Buddha is also a direct expansion of Lord Krishna. Yes, you had.
So, when we talk about developing love for Krishna, now when initially we were introduced to the Bhagavad Gita, very honestly, I could not connect. It was very mechanic because I'm supposed to feel a certain way, I used to feel a certain way. But since I started listening to your webinar lectures on the Bhagavad Gita, now there is a very natural flow of love and devotion to Krishna. It wasn't something that happened suddenly. Like even when I'm doing my own touch body healing, it is keeping in mind Krishna. There is a certain love for him that is suddenly developed. So does this kind of feeling grow, or does it?
Yes, and you should read more about his pastimes. Like all these literatures are there. They are actually helpful to us to understand who he really is, because he is the full of all the opulences more than anyone else. So as you read about him, then you get more and more attracted to those qualities. And that's how you develop more and more love for him. So you can do that study. There is a very good you know, Bhaktivedanta Prabhupada did something which is extraordinary. I don't think it has ever been done. He gave such detailed information about the spiritual that it is unparalleled, actually. So you can go to a website called vedabase.com, and this Vedabase, or is it vedabase.org, I don't know what it is, but it is an ISKCON website which lists most of Prabhupada's books and the detailed commentaries to it, and there are also other discussions and conversations he's had with his students and others. So I mean, so you can spend a whole lifetime just studying that. And the Bhagavatam is there, the Bhagavad Gita is there, Nectar of Devotion is there, Nectar of Instruction is there. So many literatures, 70, 80 books he wrote. I don't know how many are there, but there are quite a few on that website. And then there's another website called PrabhupadBooks.com. So that has also got his 1970 books, because after that there was some editing done which Prabhupada was not very happy about. But there's some editing, there's slight changes in the Vedabase version as compared to the Prabhupada books version. So I compare the two usually and see. Overall, I think they're both okay, but confusing sometimes. Sometimes confusing.
So therefore, when you explain it to us, even if it's a small paragraph, there is a much deeper connect to it than I because I tried reading many times myself.
Yeah, it's very difficult.
It's difficult.
Very difficult.
I think the love also has happened, the devotional love has also happened because of the relation of our connection to Reiki as well.
Right. And don't forget chanting of the Maha Mantra, because that will awaken love for God, actually. The chanting of the Maha Mantra awakens love for Krishna, no matter whether you know anything or you don't know anything. And you will develop all the knowledge just out of chanting Maha Mantra. There are many devotees who did nothing but chant Maha Mantra and they became enlightened. So we are not saying that we are going to be in that category, but that's how powerful it is. So just chant, study about his pastimes, read the Bhagavatam.
Is it fun to chant this mantra while driving?
I would not recommend it. People have been known to space out and reach Timbuktu, you know, on their way. Suddenly woken up, don't know where they are, you know, so don't do that. Not recommended. You should be focused on the sound. You can nod off also while driving if you are chanting, so it's not good.
I love so much you put up the Damodar Ashtakam.
Damodar Ashtakam.
It's mesmerizing and around the narration Prabhupada gives about the little fellow. It makes you want to hug his
face. Yes, yes. Yes. Yes, sure.
So this mantra which you introduced today, like you were saying about the website, and I was always hooked up to this mantra, Shri Krishna Chapter. And I did search a lot about it, but it came out to be an elemental thing, that it's for the panch tattva and you should do it before, you know, starting the Maha Mantra. And the way you explained it, it has the whole universe in it. And now I know why I was always chanting it, meditating on this mantra, but didn't know why I do it that often.
Yeah, because this is what this mantra actually gives devotion to the divine. So chanting this mantra is very good. So we usually chant this before our Bhagavad Gita class also. In fact, we invariably chant this mantra. This is invoking the entire lineage. Any questions, any comments? Anybody has a question on the web or here from the webinar? Yes.
So if we look at the Lord Ram's life, it was not easy, but he was always right, he was always correct, and there was a lot of sacrifice. In today's day and age, how do you apply that to be that right and to be correct, to try to be correct?
Well, if you are not doing anything wrong, in the sense that you're not doing any fraud, you're not doing any cheating. You are halfway there. If you are following the principles as enjoined in the Bhagavad Gita and elsewhere in the Vedas, if you are following a diet which is not encroaching on other living entities' rightful share, in other words, if you are not eating non-veg, you are further advanced, and you just keep continuing in a natural way for you. As far as your work is concerned, you do your work honestly as Master Yusui has enjoined, and you do your healing, and the results are not in your hand, never have been. So we have this idea, we'll do some work, we'll get an equivalent result. No, that's the karma mimamsa philosophy, which doesn't work. That because we are working so hard, we are bound to get results. That creates a resentment. And that's not true. In the second or third chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, people are very foolish. They are thinking, I did this and I got the results, so you know, I must keep getting those results. No, those results are arranged, pre-arranged. You are just unlocking a door. And maybe you can't unlock that door, or that door doesn't have the results you are looking for. So results are irrelevant as long as you are doing the right thing, which is that you must do whatever you are fit for. If I am fit to be an artist or to be a sculptor or to be an architect, I should not plan to become a warrior. I should not plan to become Brahmin in the technical sense, because I am going out of my capability. But it doesn't mean that wherever you are, you can't progress. You can. Technically speaking, if you look at it, sculptors, artists, painters, architects, they are considered Shudra. You know, because they are laborers. So it is not a curse word. It is not pejorative. It is a recognition of one's occupation. So Krishna says that I have created this Varnashram system according to guna and karma. Chaturvarnyam maya ashritam guna karma vibhagasa. People are taking shelter of these four ashrams and four varnas because of their qualities and their capabilities and their karma. Nothing to do with the caste system. So Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra is not caste system. There are only these four divisions of activity actually. Either it comes in the area of knowledge and education, spiritual guidance, or it comes in the area of protectionism of any kind. Shati se jo batata hai, Kshatriya, to protect from Shati, which is hurt. Then there is the Vaishyas, who are businessmen, traders, mercantile people, farmers, and the Shudras, who are the workers. So in Kali Yuga, everything is upside down. The Shudras are very elevated. All the multimillionaires, like for example the IT guys, they are Shudras, in fact. If you look at it, workers, and they are the richest. Brahmins are also the richest, which is also upside down. All the Brahmins, all the Marts, the millionaires. So everything is topsy-turvy in Kali Yuga. Rock stars, Shudras, they are the most revered and worshipped people. They are considered Marasiyas, you know. But what a following. You don't look at the news, you look at the news of your favorite pop singer or rock star or movie chap. So that is also a discredited profession, acting, movie making. You say, oh, it's very creative. Yes, lies. It's all illusion, isn't it? Nothing is true. Even the news follows similar rules. You create a reality as according to the way you want it to create it. Turn the news this way, that way. Anyway, depends who's paying your channel, who's paying you, which political party.
So you said we should do something that we're fit for. How do we know what we're fit for?
Oh, very easy to find out what you're fit for. What is it that I'm obsessed about? What do I want to do? What am I good at? What is it that I can do all the time without worrying about time passing? And I am delivering value that people will acknowledge as value. I am doing something which is of value. So it could be any profession, even singer, again falls in that last category. Without any disrespect to the singers here, but because the Gandharvas are the highest form of singers in the heavenly planets, you know, to wo sab hai. But on the earthly plane, this is not considered to be a, you know, like, you recognize the profession or occupation for what it is. It's a servant profession. If you're in the hotel business, like I was, that's a servant profession, basically. Shudra, again, whichever way you look at it. So all these things are there. So there's nothing bad about it or nothing good about it. It is what it is. And you can turn it to the better, like by, if you're in that business which you might end up in, are you planning to go there, maybe? No. So you serve prasadam to people, you reiki it, heal it. So they are also getting some spiritualized benefit. So these are then beyond material designations. But to your point that, you know, you must do what it is that you are good at, what your interest is, and that you can deliver to people as value. These are the three things. So whichever area it is. Yes, Sakshi.
Sir, yesterday, while I was just, you know, talking about news and everything, so we were talking about Ayodhya and how Diwali and how they want to create a Guinness record and they want to celebrate Diwali like never before, recreate Ram's return to Ayodhya. In my mind, there was a question that came, which is that while it's supposed to be such a pious town, holy town, why does it have such a bloody history? Why is it so murky with what happened with Babri Masjid? Why does Ayodhya have to have that if it's supposed to be such a revered town?
You know, you are now talking about Muslims and Hindus, in other words, because all these conflicts came up after the Muslims invaded India. There are no indigenous Muslims. They are all imported. Right? And it's imposed upon this culture. So today the polity of the country is saying, well, we want to change it. And I don't see anything wrong with it. Maybe they are overstepping, according to people, certain boundaries. But people, all rulers have done that in the past. When the Muslims came, they defaced everything that was our culture. So today, if there is some move to restore that, and on the way some Muslim thing falls off, you know, so it's not a Muslim thing. It is something that was there, created by a particular religious mentality, and it is linked with that. And if you want to reconfigure it, repurpose it, it's fine. Even history is rewritten all the time. I mean, your view of history is different from what it was 40 years, 50 years of anything. So many things will change again. So ultimately, histories are irrelevant from that angle. So bloody things will happen. If you look at all these places, Ayodhya is, you know, basically kingdom of, the original kingdom of a warrior. So warrior, the war hoega na. So some war with, and this is Kali Yuga, everybody is at war with themselves and with each other. So that is the norm. So warring is normal for this age. So if you go counter to that strain, then you are going in a different direction, possibly a good one. Next question. Hanji.
Balsi has a question.
Hanji.
Balsi, please go ahead and ask.
Good morning, sir.
Anji, good morning.
Happy Diwali, sir.
Happy Diwali to you too.
Sir, in a day-to-day life, if I am doing my work and channeling meaning to everything that I'm doing at house and at my workplace, and then I don't, at my workplace, if I don't think that, you know, I have to get a better job or get a higher salary and move away from this job? Is that a... I mean, I'm sort of satisfied where I work, but I was just wondering for a few days that I don't feel that one should be moving to a better job or getting more money. Is that a right attitude or am I being just lazy?
Okay, so not having that kind of material ambition, you are asking, is that laziness or you are comfortable with where you are? Well, if you have got enough, if you are keeping up with your knowledge base and your skill set, it's fine. The reason that you get upgraded job-wise, salary-wise is because you are offering something more valuable to your organization who is recognizing it by paying you more or giving you a better facility and so on. And the same if you move out to a different organization. If you are going to stagnate, that's not a good place to be. So you need to figure out whether you are stagnating or you are okay in terms of what you are delivering and how much do you want to struggle to reach higher and higher. So you could be right also in a way, but then you need to check whether you are actually, you know, you have to be careful that you don't slide into lethargy and losing your edge. So for that, I always recommend you must constantly update your skill set. I do that all the time as far as, you know, when, for example, if I'm preparing for a Bhagavad Gita class or as I prepared for today, I have to do a lot of research. It's not just flowing naturally. Bhaktivedanta Swami was a genius in a different way. He could have all these things, but he also referred to books. But you need to upgrade whatever your technical skill set is, wherever you're working. I know in some academic professions and various scientific professions, there is a truism, publish or perish. If you do not publish papers, if you don't get recognized, nobody is going to pay any attention to you. So everybody is in a rush to publish. So those kind of things you need to be aware of. What are the constraints in the field that you are? If you are financially comfortable, if you don't care, and you can get by with doing less work and focusing more on improving your spiritual quality of life, nothing wrong with that. But you should check if that is so. And whatever your obligations as a householder might be. Last couple of questions. No? Sabrina, you had a question.
Should we be observing, like on the day after Diwali, should we not be working if it is for Govardhan Puja, please?
I don't know. This is entirely up to you. It is up to you. Vishwakarma is meant for people who work with tools and equipment. That they use that day to worship their tools and equipment, which you need not do. I mean, if you are a surgeon or something, you can just channel healing to your instruments and to the activity that you do, or a doctor. If you are an engineer, you can do the same. There are a lot of people who follow this and a lot of people who don't follow this. You have a choice. Please remember, if you are a healer and you are sending healing to everything, there are no rules as such that you have to follow of the Karmakand section. Not required. It is entirely up to you. Occasions which are directly connected with the Supreme Divine and His expansions, yes, you should follow those. Focus more on developing your spiritual life. Focus more on developing your spiritual attainments, increase your knowledge base and so on. Associate with devotees, with other healers, do some congregational chanting. So in Kaliyuga it is recommended, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita that the highest yajna is japa yajna. And in Bhagavatam it is said in the Kaliyuga the highest yajna is japa yajna along with others. The congregational Sankirtan movement of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in fact. So you can do that. You can read about Krishna, you can hear about Krishna, you can think about Krishna, you can chant his name. There's a variety of activities. You're not limited to any one field. Because as human beings, we have different interests. We may not be interested in hearing for too long. We may not be interested in seeing for too long. But, you know, we can do other things. We can change. So there's a variety of things. You can prepare nice food, offer to the divine, and then eat it and share it with your friends, with your family. So we'll conclude here now. There's all prasadam is downstairs, so please go down. Thank you very much for coming.
So, Nikhil is saying happy Diwali.
Okay.
Jagjit is saying just wanted to express our gratitude and wish the master and everyone a happy Diwali.
Okay, happy Diwali to you too all. So happy Diwali to everyone. Again.
Jagjit is saying Canada se ek shudra ka pranam.
Acha. If you are a healer, you are not a shudra.
And Ophir has just said, so now after we honored Sri Hari, how should we get access to Sri Mahalakshmi grace of wealth?
You've got it already.
Happy Diwali.
You've got the grace of Mahalakshmi already. You chant the Maha Mantra, that will be good. Pray to Lakshmi Narayan, that's good. And also you can respect Lord Ganesh. Don't disrespect him, but you don't have to do any of these things if you don't want to. Understand what it is. But Lord Ram you should connect with, Lakshmi Narayan, Sita Ram. These are opulence energies. Okay? All the best. Please go downstairs.
Uttra and Prashant are wishing you happy Diwali to our dear master and the entire family.
What a mess.
Really much gratitude.
You've been listening to a discussion with Nala Narula on www.gettingpositivekarmanow.com.